kadei shorchat kapas yachat magid rachta maitzi matza. Shalom, it's a privilege and a pleasure to once again be taking part in an incredible initiative of Yeshivat Shalvim. I'd like to speak about my favorite part of the Haggadah and share with you two vorts about two very important character traits, personality traits, that every Jew should have. The Haggadah tells us, Ma'aseh Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shua, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, Rabbi Kiva, Rabbi Tarfon, Shri Masuma, Bivnei Brak. Rav Nevin saw close to Chidah as explaining that one might have had a Havamina, that these five personalities, these five great Rabbanim sitting around this table in Bnei Brak, perhaps they would not have had to take part in the Sipur of Yetzias Mitzrayim, because none of their ancestors were part of the Avdus. Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shua were Leviim, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah and Rabbi Tarfon were Kohanim, and Rabbi Kiva was a descendant of converts. So it might have been fair to say that they were putter from this mitzvah. But Rav Nevin saw Kol Nechida points out that this is an important midah of every Jew, that even though they were not part of the Avdus, even though they didn't experience the same pain and sorrow of the brethren in Mitzrayim, nonetheless, this is a national holiday. This is a holiday recalling our national Avdus and our national Cheirus. And it's imperative for every Jew to be empathic to their fellow Jew during times like these. And that's an important message for us to take with us for our lives. That even though we might not be the one going through pain or sorrow, if our brother is, if our friend is, it's something that we have to not only care about, but we have to feel that pain and celebrate when that pain is removed and the situation is resolved. Secondly, my father, Alav Shalom, always loved to quote the Aruch HaShulchan, by pointing out that Rabbi Kiva was not the most senior of the Rabbanim in this group. He was the junior rabbi, but nonetheless, all of these great Rabbanim, they came to him in Bnei Brak, they came to visit Rabbi Kiva in Bnei Brak. And the question is, why? Should not have Rabbi Kiva been going to them? Why did they come to him? The Aruch HaShulchan explains that it's safe to assume that this Seder in Bnei Brak probably took place only a couple years after Churban Beis HaMikdash, where the Kohanim and Levim around this table were partaking in the Karbanos and singing the songs. And this year, or these 2 years later, they're sitting in Bnei Brak, sad, they're mourning. They used to be able to reach this incredible spiritual high as all of Bnei Yisrael were coming together in Yerushalayim for Pesach, and now the Makom Mikdash is no longer there. And to an extent, they've lost their place. They've lost their job, and they lost their unique ability to contribute. So where do they go? Where do they go when they're feeling forlorn? They go to Bnei Brak, to Rabbi Akiva. Because we know from the Gemara Makos, Rabbi Akiva was the ultimate optimist. No matter what was happening, he would always look at the bright side. He would always try to take something that's bad and make it a little bit sweeter. As the Gemara tells us, as he saw a fox walking over Makom HaMikdash, everyone else was going crazy with pain, but he started to laugh because he said, if this Nevuah can be true, then the Nevuah of our ultimate Geula can be true as well. So Rabbi Akiva teaches us the importance of being an optimist, the importance of always looking at a bad situation and saying, hey, maybe there's good in here, maybe there's a way this could be better, maybe there's a different way we can look at it, maybe there's a way that we could take this and make it sweet. So they came to him. And for us, that's a message for us to always try to look for the sweetest in life, especially when we're around people who are sad, who are going through difficult times. If there's any way that we can make their pain any less difficult, we should follow the ways of Rabbi Akiva and try to look for the bright side. Thank you very much, and a Chag Sameach.